Simbo. remain standing for the national anthem of the brass band, followed by a word of prayer.
And protect it from all evil and all powers of darkness. as you protect all those who are going to use it. We pray in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Please be seated. Guest of honor, His Excellency Mr. Edgar Chagwa, Lungu, President of the Republic of Zambia, the Patriotic Front Secretary General, Mr. Davis Moya, the Honorable Minister of Local Government, Honorable Dr. Charles R. Banda, MP, the Honorable Minister, Honorable Elizabeth Peary, and Kanyama Member of Parliament, Honorable Minister of Chiefs and Traditional Affairs, and Kawama Member of Parliament, Honorable Lawrence Sitawe. Honorable Ministers and Members of Parliament here are present, His Excellency the Indian High Commissioner to Zambia, Mr. Volkan Datong, the President's Secretary, the Minister of Local Government, Dr. Bishop Ed Chomner, Permanent Secretary, the Senior Government Officials, the Board Chair, Rasa, the CEO of Rasa, Project Manager for AFCON Infrastructure Limited, peer officials here present at all levels, stakeholders, distinguished invited guests, members of the press, ladies and gentlemen, good morning everybody. Good morning everyone. Indeed, and welcome. I know it's a bit chilly, but our excitement and joy and pride indeed outweigh and outpower any effect that the cold can have on us this morning. Welcome, welcome to the commissioning of the Makeni Flyover Bridge here in Makeni on the Kafue Road. And this, Your Excellency, I'm sure you've taken the tour and you're very pleased, except behind the mask we can't see the big smile that is obvious on your face right now. But we have every reason, every justification to be very happy and proud because of this addition to the Zambian landscape. It's not only development, it's beautiful development. And it's something that obviously people that will be seeing it for the first time as they drive. And even those that have seen it before, I'm one, I saw it at all stages of development. And every time there was an improvement, the smile got wider and wider on my face. And so, indeed, congratulations to Your Excellency, your entire cabinet, and all those that were involved. Let's give them a big round of applause, shall we? My name is Patty Mugado, and I'm Master of Ceremonies for this event. I would now like to invite, to give the opening remarks of this occasion, the Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Local Government. This is Dr. Bishop Ed Chomner. Let's give the Permanent Secretary a big energy card for us, shall we?
Your Excellency, we bring greetings for grace and peace to you, to the Right Honorable Secretary General of our party, Honorable Davis Muina, as well as to the Minister of Laka Government, Dr. Banda. I have seen also the Chancellor of the Exchequer, Your Excellency, the Minister of Finance, as commonly referred to, as well as the Minister of Foreign Affairs. I've seen also the Right Honourable Minister of Infrastructure together with us here. I have seen other Cabinet Ministers, Honourable Peary. I've seen Honourable Sichalwe. I've seen Honourable Atotumfaya. I have seen also members of the Central Committee that are here. From the Minister of Laka Government, we send to you greetings, greetings from our hearts. Your Excellency, the month of August is what we refer to as the month of the full moon. What this means is simply that today, on the 3rd of August, the moon will make a close pass to Jupiter the planet Jupiter and Saturn in the sky. And right about an hour from now, we are going to start experiencing the full moon, as they call it. Therefore, the month of August is the month of the full moon. That is the month everything to Fichitika. And we are here, Fichitika. Your Excellency, this is the real contest. If you are going to permit us, at your ministry where we are led by Honorable Dr. Charles Gardner, to only give us 10% of infrastructure and development that you have brought into this country, there will be no billboard, there will be no book that will be able to cover what you have done. Just 10%. Therefore, Your Excellency, I want to submit this morning that this is where the real contest of politics is. Show us what you have done, we'll show you the president. Show us who talk without doing anything, we'll show you who that president is and those people are. For us, we are here. This bridge, Your Excellency, is what is referring to in other countries as a freeway. The people have got no business to do at the Cosmopolitan shopping complex and the Marquette shopping complex. There's no reason as to why we have to subject them to stop over here. Hence your thinking, Your Excellency, that we create a freeway for them. They need to fly over without any hassles or encumbrances. Your Excellency, it is for me just those remarks. Allow me, therefore, to invite to the podium to tell us more about this bridge, the Right Honorable Charles Gardner. Therefore, Your Excellency, for me, let me express gladness and happiness, and now it is my monolithic pleasure and seldom responsibility to go to the podium, the Right Honorable Dr. Charles Banda, to come and speak. Your Excellency.
By His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Zambia. It also reminds me of the day, 12 April 2018, to be precise, when His Excellency President Mr. Edgar, Chagwa, Lungu, along with Honorable President of India, Ram Nath Kovind, jointly inaugurated Lusaka City Roads Decongestion Project. It was at planned stage then, but today we stand to witness the commissioning of the most prominent part of the project, the landmark structure for Lusaka being dedicated to the nation, a tangible achievement for the government under the leadership of His Excellency, the President. The flyover bridge is intended to serve the people and to regulate the movement of traffic, giving a contemporary outlook to the city, giving shape to the vision and desires and conceptualized by JICA. I'm happy to note, and it is a matter of pride, that Afcons Limited is not only on the way to complete the project ahead of schedule, and also set a benchmark for superior quality and longevity in construction projects. All the more, I take this opportunity to express my gratitude to the government of Zambia for awarding this highly prestigious project to Afcons India Limited. And I believe the company has measured up to the expectations of the government and the people of Zambia. The beautification and upgradation of the connectivity is for all of us to see. It is commendable that despite being faced with COVID-19 pandemic for the last 5 months, the company has maintained its original timeline. Our bilateral ties over the years have been guided as much by economic impulse as by the moral principles and emotional bonds. As in the past, India stands ready to continue to extend and expand its partnership of cooperation and support to meet the aspirations of the people of Zambia in healthcare, education and training, infrastructure and energy, capacity building, in government and training extending to defense sector. The Zambia that we witness today is an example of Africa on the move. It is witnessing increasing gender parity, rising educational and health standards, and expanding infrastructure and connectivity. And as Zambia has been widely hailed in recent years for continuously maintaining peace and tranquility, it presents an exemplary model as a beacon of peace, not only to the region, but to the world at large. The COVID-19 pandemic has severely tested the resilience of all nations. Despite waging a daunting battle against COVID-19, India has acted as the pharmacy of the world by ensuring timely supply of essential drugs to more than 150 countries across the world. India also provided medicines including hydroxyl, chloroquine and related medicines to the Republic of Zambia, weighing more than 6,000 kilograms, recently to augment the force of the government of Zambia in its fight against COVID-19. The health sector is a very crucial one and being fundamental to overall socio-economic development is a priority for India. India remains committed to support Zambia in this vital sector. Construction of 650 prefabricated rural health posts, which is currently underway in the country, is a significant step in this direction. More than 400 health posts have been completed and they are playing an important role in providing basic healthcare facilities in many remote areas. During the visit of His Excellency President of the Republic of Zambia to India, an MOU on implementation of second phase of tele-education and telemedicine project titled he did that, and he Vidya Bharati and he Arogya Bharati, their book project was started. E. V. Bhatt will offer scholarships to Gangyam students over the next 5 years to pursue online short-term courses, undergraduate and postgraduate degrees from top Indian universities through the comfort of their home. E. V. Bhatt project also offers telemedicine and continued medical education for doctors, paramedics, and patients. As normal education, activities in most of educational institutions of higher learning have come to a standstill in the wake of the COVID-19. The importance of such online platforms in the field of higher education cannot be overemphasized. I am happy to share that the project is under implementation now with many Zambian students showing keen interest in the programs offered under the project. India is making development partnerships that are marked by respect, diversity, care for the future, and sustainable development. For India, the most fundamental principle in development cooperation is respect and goodwill for our partners. This sharing of developmental programs and environment is a strong motivation emanating from goodwill for mutual development. That is why a development cooperation does not come with any conditions and based on the need indicated by our development partners. It is not influenced by political or commercial considerations. And before I conclude, I congratulate all stakeholders who have worked hard for timely completion of mechanical fiber bridge. I thank the cooperation extended by the Ministry of Local Government and the Ministry of Finance to enable the smooth execution of the project, and most of all, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, that is the welcoming doorway to Zambia. I have no doubt that the Lusaka City Roads Decongestion Project, once completed, would not only address the problem of traffic congestion, but also change the landscape of the city for the benefit of all. It is also one of the examples of prioritization of people-centric politics by the government of Zambia along the lines of Vision 2030 agenda. It is my fervent hope that this project will prove to be the launching pad for further joint cooperation between the government of India and the government of Zambia for the development of infrastructure in the near future. I believe that this landmark structure being commissioned today to the nation will stand as a testimony of an enduring symbol of goodwill that exists between our two countries and continues to grow. It will foster a closer and mutual beneficial partnership for the coming years. Thank you.
Thank you, Your Excellency. That was the High Commissioner of India to Zambia, Mr. Gokhan Jatop, giving his remarks. And, yes, I believe we are all happy and proud of the relationship between Zambia and India and all the benefits that are being, mutual benefits that are being reaped from that relationship. Now may I invite to address us, he was invited already, the Minister of Local Government, Honorable Dr. Charles Arbata, MP, to address us. Sir.
Thank you very much, Master of Ceremonies. Your Excellency, first of all, before I begin the address, it is the important actor who is very proud of his name. The one I've known since I started listening to radio is the gentleman who has went to the microphone. He really makes sure that everybody understands. His name is Paddy Mokando. And he was no different from George Mwambatisha. These two. Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Zambia, Dr. Edgar Chagwa, the Patriotic France Secretary General, Mr. Davis Muya, Honorable Elizabeth Kiri, Member of Parliament, Kanyama Constituency, and the Minister for Gender, Honorable Lawrence Sitiawe, Member of Parliament for Chawama, and the Minister of Chiefs and National Affairs, all the honorable members, ministers and members of parliament present, His Excellency, India's High Commissioner to Zambia, the Permanent Secretary for Local Government, senior government officials present, the board chairpersons of road sector agencies present, chief executive officers present, the project manager, Mr. Subrato, all other representatives from Kafue Infrastructure Limited, members of the press, distinguished invited guests, ladies and gentlemen. Your Excellency, we are most grateful that you accepted the invitation to grace this occasion. Allow me to give you a brief overview of the Osaka Reconnection Road project. This project was necessitated by rapid population increase in the city, which led to congestion on the major roads, thus impacting social and economic activities. It is co-financed through a partnership that shares 15% contribution from the Zambian government and 85% contribution from the Indian government through Exim Bank of India. This project commenced, Your Excellency, on 1st June 2018 and has a duration of 36 months. Your Excellency, the President, the project has the following features. One, approximately 91.4 kilometers of roads earmarked for either rehabilitation, widening, or new construction. Number two, the further with 9.3 kilometers earmarked for widening and provision of dedicated bus lanes. Number three, four new flyovers to be constructed at Munani roundabout, Long Rivers roundabout, Arcades, and here where we are at Makeni Junction. The Makeni Junction flyover happens to be the first one to have been completed, and this is the reason why we are here today. And finally, the construction of the office block in Long Rivers for the Ministry of Local Government. Your Excellency, the project is being executed on the engineering procurement and contracting basis by AFCON's Infrastructure Limited of India. The consulting engineers are Allion Consulting Engineers Limited of Zambia, and they are working closely with engineers from the Ministry of Local Government and also the Osaka City Council. I wish to further state that in line with the government's policy on subcontracting of construction works, 20% of the contract sum has been reserved, Your Excellency, for the Zambian subcontractors. I'm glad to report that the project has engaged 60 local contractors undertaking various works. Additionally, as part of the project, there is a component for capacity building in construction aimed at building capacity of the local contractors and consultants to carry out future construction works. Your Excellency, in terms of feasible progress, the project has significantly advanced and is ahead of schedule by nearly 6 months. Currently, feasible progress stands at 70%, with an ambitious target for completing the works by end of December 2020. So far, several roads have been completed and handed over. Roads such as Mosotunya, Kangwena, Mabona, and Lake Road have all contributed to decongesting some of the busiest routes and completed the face of Osaka. Another spectacle is this bridge being commissioned today. This progress, Your Excellency, would not have been possible without your continued support and guidance. I therefore wish to sincerely thank you for the support and leadership which you have rendered on this project. Your Excellency, with these remarks, Allow me now to invite you to now officially commission the McKinney Flyover Bridge and open it to the public. Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Zambia.
I wish to remind the project team that even can we talk about the causing people to reconnect, we must remain cognizant of the need to continuously support the lives of motorists, cyclists, and pedestrians. I'm glad to note that all safety measures have been taken into consideration in this project. Saving lives and prevention of accidents is essential not only for economic purposes, but because we treasure the lives of our people. The Federal Front Government will therefore continue to provide infrastructure that safeguards human life. Ladies and gentlemen, infrastructure development is a critical catalyst to enhance economic growth, and therefore, my government will continue to invest in infrastructure such as roads, schools, hospitals, and any other such infrastructure, no matter what our detractors will say. I have heard some sections of our people arguing that they cannot eat roads, and as such, government should not invest so much in infrastructure. To the contrary, provision of essential infrastructure is key to unlocking the economic potential of our country, resulting in many benefits to our people. As such, my government will not be distracted whatsoever or detracted whatsoever from doing that which is necessary for our people. We will not relent from providing necessary infrastructure. You can chop, we continue working because our people are not. Apart from infrastructure development, my government is determined to create various jobs, especially for growing youth population. I have been informed that through this project, over 1,000 direct jobs have been created for men and women. Additionally, several other indirect jobs have also been created through various other ancillary businesses resulting from this project. Of any infrastructure is dependent on the design, and therefore it is necessary to ensure that any infrastructure put up incorporates appropriate designs that assure value for money. I'm delighted to note that the infrastructure I'm commissioning today is a result of rigorous engineering processes and has undergone tests making it ready for use by the public. This is the type of engineering we need in this country. My government will continue to support forward-looking engineering professionals who remain resolute to supporting government's efforts in good infrastructure provision. Ladies and gentlemen, apart from the benefits of the road and reduced traffic congestion, I'm glad to be informed that the consulting engineers for this project are from a local company, which shows that our engineering profession is growing and expertise. The skills and knowledge generated through such projects will go a long way in improving our infrastructure using local resources. I'm also aware that 61 local factors have been engaged on these projects. These local contractors are not only performing waste, but are also enhancing the technical and commercial skills required for infrastructure development and management. Building the capacity of local contractors to undertake such projects is essential for lowering the cost of providing future infrastructure. This infrastructure will require maintenance, and it is these same local contractors whose capacity has been built who will undertake necessary maintenance. Ladies and gentlemen, I take this opportunity to thank the people of Zambia for the patience exhibited and compliance during the ongoing construction research and this project and many other such projects. I'm aware that many of you must have been convinced one way or another due to the receiving of the project, leading some disruption of operations within businesses, access to property, and in extreme cases, they have resulted in the closure and restriction of roads leading to traffic congestion. These inconveniences are necessary to allow the project team to diligently and expeditiously execute their duty. We shall soon be enjoying the fruits of the patience and tolerance of these diligent, and I say, bear with us. Ladies and gentlemen, today we are commissioning the completion of machine flyover, which, as you have already heard, is one of the four flyover bridges to be constructed in Osaka in this project. The benefit of the machine flyover bridge will be immediate, because the travel time between the few around 1,000 kilometers will reduce to nearly half, as the freeway will not be burdened by turning or joining vehicles at the Chagwa machine junction. I keep reminding myself that I shouldn't talk too much. I should be waiting because time for talking is coming with the part of the show. So let me just now take this opportunity to thank all of you for coming to witness this occasion, and also allow me to commission the flyover bridge and go back to work so that the people can begin using it. For this as well, for the Zambia and
thank you. Thank you very much, Your Excellency. Another big round of applause for the President. Indeed, sir. They say actions speak louder than words. And I think we're all witnesses to the actions that you have produced. And we thank you even for your words today. You labor on for this beautiful nation. That was also a right to add it to voice. So from the city of choir to sing one song that they join in the organization of the celebration of the city of choir. Thank you so very much. And now the last item for the last part of the paper for today is the vote of thanks. You asked the question. So allow me to invite both members of parliament, both members and the
We are proud. that you wrote that book to places where there are no people. And what I enjoy, you know, between us, and I hope. Your Excellency, we have seen leadership that has never been there before. I also want to thank the government of India for their contribution in this project. It takes a good person to a good friend. If you are not a good leader, Indian government wouldn't have come to pay. So because of your good leadership, Your Excellency, you are able to have a friend with your friends in other government. We have Indian voices. But let me just say thank you for agreeing to come here.
Thank you.